In this video, I'll walk through a few examples of converting units. This is often called dimensional analysis. Convert the following units: 3.45 meters to centimeters. We'll start with this lob ball. We have 3.45 meters. And this is how I like to set it up. Set it up as a fraction. You can make anything into a fraction by putting it over one. And then if you have something like miles per hour, you can put the miles in the numerator and the hour in the denominator. And then what that lets you do is cancel out units if you need to, or you will need to. Okay, now let's say we know that there are 100 centimeters for every meter. Well, where do we put the 100? Is it going to be in the numerator or denominator? Do we multiply by 100 or divide by 100? And I'm doing this easy one in the beginning because you can kind of jump to this answer. You know, I know it's going to be 345 centimeters, but let's walk through the process because then you know how to do it when the problem gets more complicated. So what we always want to do is to make sure we know we want to get rid of the meters because we're going away from that. So I'm going to put that in the denominator so that it will cancel with the meters in the numerator up here. And then I'll put centimeters up in the other place, in the numerator in this case. Okay, so then we write these numbers. We've got 100 centimeters for every 1 meter. Now, the meters cancel out, and just like we guessed, this was going to be 3.45 times 100 is 345. So I have 345 centimeters. And I know you may have learned to just move the decimal by a number of places when you're converting in the metric system. And that's great. If you're comfortable with that, do it, because that is a nice, fast way. But when we start going into this next example where you can't just slide the decimal point, I want you to know that you can always come back to this fraction setup, this dimensional analysis. Okay, 12 pounds to grams. So just like in the last example, I'm going to write the 12 pounds up in the numerator. And then what do we have? Well, I don't know the exact number of grams to a pound, but I do know that there are 2.2 pounds. I'm putting pounds in the denominator here because we want to cancel pounds out, to 1 kilogram. And when I do that, what that lets me do is cancel out the pounds. But we want to go to grams, and now we're left with just kilograms. Well, we just take one more step then. Now, grams is our dimension, is our unit, and so we are going to multiply by something to cancel out the kilograms. So kilograms is going to go in the denominator, and I'll put grams in the numerator. So that is, we have 1,000 grams for every 1 kilogram. So I'm going to put the 1,000 by the grams, and I'm going to put the 1 by the kilogram. And again, that let us cancel out the kilograms. And so we're left with what we want, the grams. Now, performing all of this mathematics, that's 12 times 1,000 and then divided by 2.2, that leaves us with an answer of 5,454.54 repeating. Let's stay with the significant figures here. We have two significant digits, so I'm just going to round to 5.5 times 10 to the third, and the label is grams. Okay, this last one. How many grams of lead are in 6.0 kilograms of blood if the lead content is 0.40 parts per million? Okay, so we have a starting point and an ending point. By the way, this is the typical amount of blood in a person, about 6 kilograms, and this is considered about normal, acceptable, 0.4 parts per million, 0.4 parts of lead per million parts of blood is the way that is understood. Okay, 6.0 kilograms of blood. That's our starting point, so we'll write that down first. 6.0 kilograms, and I'm going to put the label blood here because we're ultimately going to be canceling out this blood because we're ending with lead. We're ending with, I'll underline this, ending with grams of lead, starting with kilograms of blood. Okay, I'll put this over 1, and now what do we have as a conversion? Well, we are given that we have 0.40 parts of lead per million parts of blood. So again, staying with this format, we want to get rid of blood. We want to cancel out blood. So I'm going to put it in the denominator so that it cancels out the blood in the numerator over here. And I'll put lead in the numerator, what we're multiplying here in this fraction. And we have 0.40 parts of lead for every 1 million, one more, 1 million parts of blood. All right, so we've got those numbers in there correctly, and that lets us cancel out the word blood. And so now what we have is kilograms of lead, but we want grams of lead. So let's do that final conversion to convert from kilograms to grams, and that's what we did over here. So I'll put 1 kilogram for every 1,000 grams. Again, I put kilograms in the denominator so that we could cancel out the kilogram from this numerator because we're just multiplying fractions here. That's all we're doing. And we're doing it in such a way so that we keep the labels we want and get rid of the labels we don't want. So we've gotten rid of kilograms. We've gotten rid of blood. We are left with what we want, and that is grams of lead. So doing the math on all that, 6.0 times 0.40 times 1,000, and then all divided by 1 million, that brings us to an answer of 0.0024 grams of blood, or I could write that as 2.4 times 10 to the negative third in scientific notation. Grams, I said grams of blood, it's grams of lead. Sounds pretty dangerous, but that is not that much. And so we have it in our system, and it's not that much. It's not hurting us so far. Now, if you found this video helpful, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.